I am Dr. W. Vegonode from Kamala Nehru Mahavidyalaya Nagpur. Today we are discussing the free radical intermediate compound. Already we have discussed carbonium ion, carbanion, and today we are discussing the third reaction intermediate, that is free radical. And we know what is free radicals. Free radicals contains odd number of electrons or unshared electron pair on the species, and this odd electron, due to the presence of this, it is a free radical. And there are different types of free radicals: methyl free radical, ethyl free radical, or chlorine free radicals are there. And this free radical is again now highly reactive chemical species, and it is a short-lived and also sometimes known as a nucleophile. And here we are going to discuss about the free radicals. So what is free radicals? After that, what are the types of free radicals? Then formation of free radicals. So generally the free radicals are formed by homolytic fission. As we know, carbanion is formed by the heterolytic fission, but this free radical is formed by homolytic fission. And after that, we are going to see what is the stability of free radical. So it is observed that the stability of free radicals are similar to the carbonium ion. So we are discussing in detail about this free radical today. So now topic is again mechanism of organic reaction, and this is part number 5. In this part we are discussing the reaction intermediate, third number, free radicals. So topics covered here are the free radicals. What is free radical? Generation or formation of free radicals, classification of free radicals, and stability of these free radical. So first of all, we should have to know what is free radicals. So we can say that any species which is having odd or unshared electron is known as the free radical. And in contrast to the carbonium or carbanion ion, these have no charge. They are formed by homolytic bond fission. So this is the carbanion, and examples of carbanion is shown here. Some of the examples: chlorine free radical, methyl free radical, phenyl free radical, so odd electrons is there, benzyl free radical, triphenyl methyl free radical. So these are the examples of free radicals. So we can say that free radicals are the chemical species with odd or unshared or unpaired electron is known as the free radicals. Now in case of free radical, electrically it is neutral, have no any charge, and presence of odd electron, they are weakly attracted by the magnetic field, and therefore it is, due to the presence of one electron on the species, they are paramagnetic in nature. And free radicals are also short-lived and highly reactive chemical species because of their tendency to acquire one more electron to complete the octet. And this free radical is also sometimes known as electrophile, because one electron short to complete the octet, and therefore are having one electron here, and therefore it is also act as a nucleophile, electrophile. And after this, now how these free radicals are formed, that you are going to see. So four methods have been shown here for the formation of free radicals. So free radicals are generally formed by homolytic fission. What is homolytic fission? After breaking the bond, of the cleavage of the bond, what is, each one electron goes to both the species. So equal, homo means same. Same distribution of electron is there of the covalent bond after breaking. So either by heat or by light. So this homolytic fission is carried out by the presence of heat, or by the heat or by light. So this homolytic fission of the covalent bond takes place by heat or by light. Examples have been shown here. Four examples are there. First example, this is chlorine molecule, and now this is the shared electron pair. After homolytic fission, so we get this chlorine free radical in this way. Another example is there, benzoyl peroxide. So this is the peroxide linkage. After this breakage, what is in the presence of heat or light, we obtain this phenyl free radical. So this is shown here, phenyl free radical. Third example, general example is given, that is ketone or anyone. So this is CO, and now this bond undergo breaking, and forming this, after breaking, what is this carbon have one electron, this alkyl have one electron. So this is the alcyl free radical and alkyl free radicals are formed. Acyl and alkyl free radicals are formed. This is tetramethyl lead. Tetramethyl lead, and after heating, what we get? Methyl free radicals, and PB is the metal. So methyl free radicals. So in this way, after homolytic fission of the covalent bond, we get different types of free radical. Chlorine free radical, phenyl free radicals, or alkyl free radicals, or methyl free radicals. So different types of free radicals are there, and obtained by the are prepared by the homolytic fission. So this is the generation of free radical in the organic compound. Now the free radicals are of the again primary, secondary or tertiary. So free radicals are classified into primary, secondary or tertiary depending upon the carbon atom carrying the unpaired electron is primary, secondary, tertiary in nature. So this is methyl free radical, this is ethyl free radical, isopropyl free radical, tertiary butyl free radical. So this is tertiary, secondary, primary, and this is methyl free radical. So we can classify free radical into primary, secondary or tertiary. So these are the different types of free radical. Next part is the orbital structure. Now in case of orbital structure of this free radical, and alkyl free radicals are planar chemical species. Carbon atom carrying the odd electron, and this carbon is sp2 hybridized. sp2 means the shape is trigonal planar. This is the trigonal planar, but unhybridized orbital have this odd electron. So sp2 hybrid orbitals of this carbon form 3 sigma bond with monovalent atoms or groups which are in a plane and inclined to one another, and bond angle in case of trigonal planar is 120 degrees. The unhybridized orbital, which is perpendicular to the plane and contains odd electron, this is the odd electron, this is unhybridized orbital, this is shown unhybridized, and the 1, 2, 3 alkyl forming sigma bond and with a trigonal planar geometry and bond angle is 120. So in case of trigonal planar, regular bond angle is 120 degrees, and one unhybridized orbital is there, this is shown by dumbbell shape, this is unhybridized and having p orbital having odd electron. So this is the orbital picture in case of free radical. So we can say that this is a compound having trigonal planar shape, and in which the carbon is sp2 hybridized, and odd electron present in the p orbital which is unhybridized. And in the next slide shown that we are going to discuss the stability of the free radical. So in case of stability of the free radicals, it can also be explained on the basis of two. One is hyperconjugation and second is resonance effect. So first is hyperconjugation effect and on the basis of resonance effect. So on the basis of hyperconjugation effect, the stability of alkyl free radical have the order. So in case of free radical, the stability order is, in case of alkyl free radical, tertiary is more stable than secondary, which is more stable than primary, which is more stable than methyl. Again, now this order is similar to the order found in case of carbonium ion. So here tertiary butyl free radical, so shown here, this is the carbon having odd electron, and this is the trimethyl compound, so known as tertiary butyl free radical. This is isopropyl free radical, this is secondary. This is methyl or ethyl free radical and primary. This is methyl free radical. So these are the structures, and order is found to be tertiary, secondary, primary, and then methyl. This order of the stability can be easily explained on the basis of hyperconjugation effect. Greater the number of alpha hydrogens, greater is the number of hyperconjugative structures, and hence more stable is the free radical. Therefore, tertiary butyl free radical with 9 alpha hydrogens and hence 9 hyperconjugation structures is more stable as compared to isopropyl free radical with 6 alpha hydrogen and hence 6 hyperconjugation structure, which is also more stable than ethyl free radical with 3 alpha hydrogens and hence three hyperconjugation structure, while methyl free radical with no alpha hydrogens has no hyperconjugative structure and therefore it is a least stable. So because of the presence of alpha hydrogens here, this is more stable. Tertiary butyl free radical is more stable, then this one, then primary, and lastly this, because it, this methyl group have no any alpha hydrogens. So here there is no alpha hydrogen, therefore there is no any hyperconjugative structures, and therefore it is a least stable. So in this case, this is least stable, then this one. So this is the order. So tertiary butyl free radical is more stable. So this order is similar to the stability of carbonium ion. And here is shown how the hyperconjugative structures are there. So this is alpha, this is alpha, this is alpha. In case of tertiary butyl free radical, three hydrogens are here, alpha, this three and three, total nine. So different structures are possible. See here, this is structure one, this is structure two, this is structure three, like that. So different structures are possible. Here one example is shown how we can make the structure. This is one, this is two, this is three. So this, in the similar way, there are total nine hyperconjugative structures are there, and therefore it is more stable. In case of isopropyl free radical, in this case, this is the carbon, these three and these three, total six alpha hydrogens are there, and therefore they form only six hyperconjugative structures. And so here are the nine alpha hydrogens, and hence nine equivalent hyperconjugative structure. In this case, six hyperconjugative structures are possible. In case of ethyl free radical, this is alpha, only three. This is the carbon and having three, this is carbon having three alpha hydrogens, and therefore there are three hyperconjugative structures, and therefore here are 9, 6 and 3, and methyl have no any structure. So this can be explained, or we can say the stability of the free radical can be explained on the basis of hyperconjugative effect, and number greater the number of hyperconjugative structure, more stable is the compound. So in case of this, tertiary butyl is more stable than isopropyl, which is more stable than ethyl, which is more stable than methyl free radicals. So in this way, tertiary butyl free radical is more stable, and methyl free radical is least stable. So this is an example how the hyperconjugative structures are formed. Now second is the stability of free radical. In case of this, second effect is the resonance effect. And in case of resonance effect, it also explains the stability, and a free radical can be stabilized by resonance, even more stable than simple alkyl free radical. For example, allyl and benzene free radicals are stabilized by resonance through the delocalization of unpaired electron over the double bond or the benzene ring. So example is shown here, because of the delocalization of unpaired electron over to the double bond or the benzene ring, stability is there. So stability or resonance effect explain the stability of free radical. So this is the resonance structure of allyl free radical. This is allyl, and this is another structure of allyl, and because of two structures, they this is a shifted free radical electron. In case of benzyl free radical, this is benzyl. Now we have seen this is shifted here, this is electron here, now here delocalization of electron, then here and again here. So this is the delocalization of electron. Because of this, they show different structures, and therefore it is more stable. So stability of the free radical can also be explained by the resonance effect. So two factors are there. One is a hyperconjugation effect, and second is a resonance effect. On the basis of these two effect, we can explain the stability of the free radical. So today in this part, we have discussed different part, that is the in case of the free radical. So what is free radical? What are the types of free radical? How to classify the free radicals, and formation of free radicals, and the stability of free radicals. So all these part we have discussed today. This is the reaction intermediate. So we have already discussed the carbonium ion, carbanion, and now this is free radical. So free radical is a chemical species with one what is the odd electron on the species. This is known as the free radical, and this free radical is formed by the homolytic fusion of the covalent bond. So today we stop here and we will discuss the carbene, another that is the reaction intermediate, in the next part.